Oh, there's a pretty great interview at the moment out with Kerwin Frost on his channel with Jerry Lorenzo, of course, from Fear of God. And he talks really well about his obviously internal journey overall. I'm about halfway through it now at the moment. But there's this really great clip that's been taken out of it that basically people are spreading across social, where he essentially talks about being a creative director of a fashion house, and that's not something that he kind of wanted to do. And he always wanted to kind of get into the game to build his own thing and kind of build that into being the next Ralph. And it's really, really inspiring and really great to see somebody at the level that he's at also reminding other kids that are coming up in streetwear designing and stuff that it's not always about just being accepted by the fashion people, because there's this weird thing around it in streetwear now at the moment. I'm not too sure what happened and when that changed, but it's definitely something I've noticed. But definitely, grateful that Jerry Lorenzo kind of spoke upon it and hopefully lend some sort of credence to the idea that, making your brand and making it into being whatever you want it to be, and in this current era we're living in now at the moment, should be enough. You shouldn't just be looking for validation from fashion people, especially considering how nutty that whole industry is in general. So this is the clip.
Being home during the pandemic just gave
Really?
me a greater desire to just be here in Los Angeles
Yeah.
and take my girls to horseback riding or take my son to baseball. And I want to build something.
Yeah.
My desire has always been to build Fear of God.
Yeah.
I wasn't a fashion kid, so I never had an aspiration to like be a part of something or an industry where I never felt wanted anyhow. And
Yeah.
so it's just not in me to desire to want to be a creative director. Not to say that people are calling me to be a creative director. That's not
Yeah.
the case, but
Oh.
it's just not in me. My desire is to build Fear of God to Ralph Lauren Heights.
Yeah.
That's what I want to do. I want to
Yeah,
be a
that's
business owner
amazing.
and creative direct my own journey. And why do we as people of color or from streetwear need to feel like we need to be validated by
Yeah, at
doing
someone
something
else's
like that?
house.
And so I'm not chasing that validation. And not to say that anyone that has done that is chasing anything. And I
Right.
think that, what Virgil is doing and what Matt is doing at the level that they're doing it, Virgil is carrying his cross
Oh,
that
yeah.
allows me to carry my own cross here. And
Yep. Likewise. And
some
so forth.
indirect way, he's
Yeah.
validating what I'm doing by him doing
100%.
that. And so he does that, so I don't have to do that. You know what I'm
Yeah.
saying? Ho did
Yeah.
that, so you don't got to do that.
Yeah.
So it's like I know what my calling is, I know what I want to say,
Yeah.
and I think I learned a lot from that Zegna opportunity in terms of
Yeah.
like the pushback, what you may get from a house.
Right.
And I want to say what I want to say, and
Yep.
I don't have the bandwidth to like fight with you on like my perspective, and I need
Yeah.
the freedom to express myself how I want to, when I want to. We don't put collections out on the fashion calendar, we put them
Yeah.
out when they're ready.
Yep.
And so I need the freedom to be able to do that, and that's a part of who we are. And to get on that like track and that treadmill is something that is just not attractive at
Yeah,
all.
no.
For
If you remember correctly, if you've been keeping an eye on what Jerry Lorenzo has been doing in his career, you would be familiar that he's been saying this for a while. Because I remember one time, I forgot what interview it was, but there was one particular one where he mentioned how he felt a little bit put out when he went to Paris and he kind of carried a suitcase full of some early samples of Fear of God, and he felt like people were kind of sunning him a little bit. It might have been during the time when he went to Paris and he attended that Vetements show, right? The first Vetements show, because I'm pretty sure he's in the crowd, he's in the front row. Because I remember they're playing like a Boys Noize track that we never actually got a track ID for in the end because he never released it. But he's in the front row, sort of aggressively nodding his head. I think that was the same sort of time. And he said, oh, he kind of felt a little bit sunned, like they kind of shot a big timing out there in Paris, even though he was making the stuff himself by hand and sort of looking for help and maybe retailers or whatever it may be. I don't know what it was. But he kind of always, from that conversation, it did kind of seem like he saw what it's like to actually be a part of the system and be in there, being around amongst fashion people, and he suddenly realized out there, you know what, this isn't for me. He obviously still goes out there to, support friends or whatnot, I'm guessing, and do whatever he needs to do for his brand. But in terms of being part of the machine, he's always kind of been away from that. And I would assume as well, with the Zegna collaboration that was, beautiful from what we saw, you can just imagine what the conversations were like behind the scenes, right? Putting that collection together, the sensibilities and the taste levels and the work, you know, practices and the approach and the tone of voice that some Americans and people from Europe have, especially, you know, very rich and aristocratic sort of posh Italians from a very storied house like Zegna. You can imagine the kind of cultural differences that sort of arose from that collaboration. And in the end, we got, you know, great products from it. You know, we got that amazing snapback that probably will go down in history as one of the best snapbacks of all time. But overall, I can imagine what would have happened behind the scenes. Probably would have been another reminder for him, hey, just do your own thing and kind of run your own course. And I think it's healthy as well, in it seemed, to have each person doing things their own way, each person doing things really well in their own little different way. You know, the way Matthew Williams is running Givenchy, or being able to run Givenchy, isn't the same way that Louis Vuitton or Virgil gets to do at Louis, isn't the same way that Virgil does his Off-White thing, isn't the same way that, you know, Jerry's doing his Fear of God and Essentials. They're all doing things in their different sort of ways, and I like that approach about things, and it gives kids coming up different examples that they can follow, so they don't all have to kind of follow the same route. And I would assume, again, I get the allure with Paris and fashion in general, because like I've mentioned in other shows, I was a little bit of a naysayer too to the industry by and large, because I would count myself more as a kid, a product of streetwear, right? That's where I got my entire education from. I owe a lot to that entire scene, you know, worldwide, for kind of educating me on many, many different things, from art to fashion to design and whatever it may be. But I did realize when I went to my first show, that was one of the Virgil shows, I forgot which one it was, or the one where Ian Connor runs out at the end of the runway, I was there for that show, and I did get to experience what it's like to be somebody that's quote unquote invited and sort of like, you know, taken around to certain places, you know, invited to certain after parties and gallery openings, whatever, not what during that whole time, like an influencer would be. And it's a pretty dope experience. So I can only imagine what it's like to be an actual brand owner, right? Somebody that's actually making the things and not just consuming it. It must be wonderful, right, to be with these people, having dinner, sharing stories and talking about your design ethos and your whatever it may be, and then getting this weird kind of different level of validation from these European people, right, who seem to have a lot more culture and sophistication than you, especially if you think you're this oaf from North America. I can imagine why it can be somewhat alluring, but again, like I said, I think it is deceiving, because they're a little bit transactional and a little bit kind of seasony, and, you know, in the moment with you anyway, you're the hot thing now, and then you're not the hot thing later. You know, they were in love with skaters for a couple of seasons and they fell out of love again, then recently they love streetwear, and suddenly they're writing op-eds about the death of streetwear, the return of tailoring, which I took to be a bit of a dog whistle to getting all the blacks and, you know, brown people out of fashion and whatever it may be. So I guess in general, they don't really want us to be there. So I don't really see why we kind of have to always kind of curtail and bend and sort of appease what they're kind of into. But again, I understand the money, the access, the resource, all that sort of stuff is on that side of things. But there is still a lot on the outside of things when it comes to streetwear, dealing with it. But you just need to be able, you just need to kind of, I wouldn't say be able, you kind of have to know, I'd imagine, what you kind of got in it for, right? If you're happy with kind of supplying and providing for your little community of people, you know, being able to do some really cool collaborations, you know, be a valuable member of your peer group, have a great store, whatever it may be, then there's definitely avenues for it. But the moment you want to try and expand and kind of push into bigger markets and whatnot, you're inevitably going to have to touch those kind of people. But like I said, I think it's really refreshing that, you know, Jerry was able to kind of speak about the desire and the need to kind of just stay doing what he's doing to a high level, and that's enough for him. And hopefully other kids will see that and maybe take that as an example going forward. Hopefully.